Blogger Roundup. It's myOrganized.life live, April 25th, 2019. Hold the presses. It's Thursday,
it's
not
Thursday,
Friday.
Yes.
Blogger Roundup is Fridays.
Well,
and, no.
As we said
okay.
a while ago, for the next like 4 or 5 Fridays,
it's going to be a while.
We're
going
to be gone. So tomorrow we're going to be gone. So we're moving Blogger Roundup to Thursday.
Okay.
You're going to be out of here.
I will.
After this. Pretty much right away after this
pretty
show.
Pretty much, yeah. So
you're going to be checked out.
Get this posted. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, so what are we talking about? This is myorganized.life live. I'm John Hunt.
And I am Leanne Thompson.
And this is the show where we give you organizing tips, advice, and on Fridays.
Or
Thursdays now for the next who knows how long, right?
Who knows?
That means there's going to be no solutions. Maybe we'll have to move solutions to Wednesday. Well, then the podcast
no,
will have to move.
No.
We'll take it one day at a time. But
right.
Let's put up that first slide for Blogger Roundup.
Blogger Roundup is the other side of organized. Linda Samuels, how to let go of perfect with humor for the greater good.
Ooh.
And she is basically talking about when you're hosting events, parties, what
mm-hmm.
have you, there's always something that's going to go wrong.
Seriously.
Like so this. She was saying that in the last 30-some years of her marriage,
mm-hmm.
her and her husband have hosted over 100 events.
Oh boy.
Birthday parties, you name it, holidays, all that stuff.
Wow.
And they each have their own kind of chores, duties, or whatever
right.
you want to call them when it comes to getting ready for the party, but they have
mm-hmm.
also learned to accept things. And so she talks about 5 lessons learned about letting go of perfect, because
okay.
as we all know,
it's not going to be
perfect, and it never will be.
Especially like all those weddings, you know, people want to do, it's a perfect wedding. Oh, but it's raining outside. What happened to the photo
shoot? The bridesmaid split her dress
yes.
a half an hour before the ceremony.
Oh.
Who has the sewing kit?
Okay, so
right?
what's
okay.
her first little
first
humorous relief?
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Yep,
planning is terrific, but you will forget something.
Oh, yes.
You'll forget maybe an ingredient for that salad or those brownies. You're going to have to go back to the store.
Yes.
So instead of just getting mad and frustrated, just roll with it. Okay.
Hop in the car and
happen,
go get
I've
it.
I've got to go.
Yes.
Instead of letting it put a damper on everything.
This is where living like 2 or 3 blocks from a Target really is helpful.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
In my case, a supermarket.
Okay. Nice.
And then second one, no you don't.
No,
have
you don't.
To do everything yourself.
That's nice.
So
I like
John,
that.
What can I bring to your party?
Well, why don't you bring like a turkey for 15 people?
Sure, I'd love to.
And I'll bring the napkins.
All right.
That's
there
about.
You go.
That's
yes.
our. That's like our potlucks here, you know.
Yeah.
You know, I'll bring the little thing, and you know, they bring in this crock pot. I feel so bad. It's like
you
I didn't.
You bring like the dollar store bag of chips.
Yeah. And nobody eats them.
Because they're gross.
Yeah, and then I end up eating them later.
Yeah,
it's
anyway.
Sad. Oh gosh.
So let
okay.
people bring stuff if they want.
Right. Yeah.
Okay?
That's a good thing to do. It helps making parties a lot easier.
Exactly. And help is good is another one.
Okay. Help
is good.
If people
want to help you do the dishes, let them.
Yes.
People feel more comfortable when they're helping rather than they're being, you know, waited on like. Oh, can I get you some more crumpets or whatever?
You know, it's interesting, you know. I think some people say, hey, well, can I help you? Can I help you do anything?
Yeah.
Knowing that, well, you're going to say, oh, no, I got it all.
Right.
But, you know, I don't really want to help you, but I'm just going to say it. And then, oh, yeah, go ahead
sure.
and mop the floor for
yeah,
me.
Yeah, why don't you take out this...
take this garbage
to
out.
Take this turkey roaster and clean it
yeah.
so I don't have to later.
Yes. Will you wash my windows
yes.
for me while we're waiting? Okay, all right.
Okay, the real plan. There will be last-minute cancellations, additions, or emergencies. You'll never know.
Yes.
So just let go of exactness.
Yes. No exactness.
Not everything is always going to go to 100% plan.
Right. Okay.
And then what's your why? Let
what's
go of all expectations. Just have fun. Remember
yeah.
that people are coming over to enjoy themselves. Not
right.
to look at, you know, under your TV stand to see if
right.
there's dust or not. Just
I haven't
have
seen this person for, you know, a year. That's
yeah,
the main reason
exactly.
to get together. Okay,
yes.
let's
so,
put the slide up for
the
that one.
The other side of organized, Linda Samuels, how to let go of perfect with humor for the greater good.
I love it. Okay, next slide up, professional-organizer.com, Ellen DeLapp, Spring Organizing Technology Edition.
Ooh.
It sounds like it's going to be a listing of all the hottest new organizing apps, but this is not Deb Lee.
This is not Deb Lee. Deb Lee would have that.
Yes, she would. Okay, but...
Not that Ellen is not technologically savvy.
Right, but you know, when you read that headline, you go, oh, well, what's this all about? Well, this is actually a good blog. You want to read this because it talks about some of the things that you should do in organizing the technology you already have.
Okay.
Not things you're going to get. So, inventory and edit. So you, where the heck is the tech? Is her line. Where the heck is the tech?
I thought you just made that up. I thought that was pretty clever.
No, I'm not that smart. Okay. So go through your home and office and just kind of find out what you have and where it is. Kind of make an inventory.
So grab the chargers, grab the flash drives, grab everything that
you where everything is.
Possibly could need.
Then plan for recycling. Not necessarily, this is part of it, you know, the stuff you got to get rid of that's like sitting in your garage or
in a closet. Our extra computer in our garage.
Yeah, our extra two in our. But no, she's actually talking about, and we kind of touched on this the other day when our technology decluttering.
Yes.
But you know, clear off your desktop on your computer and extra files that you don't need. Keep that, you know, send them to the recycling bin on your computer. Mm-hmm. I don't know what do they call it on a Mac. Do they call it recycle or
trash?
Okay.
I don't know.
You know. Anyway, clear the clutter from your technology. Okay. And there are other places, like if you have out of date equipment. Locally, there's a lot of different places that will take your old technology and reuse it.
Yeah, sometimes it's like a once a year or twice a year type deal.
So recycle that stuff. Okay, choose central storage. Now, we're not talking about cloud storage here. We're talking about, do you have a place where you can kind of put your technology so you know where everything is because everything is in its place? So, like, do you have a drawer or something where...
Everything for the chargers, yeah, like, every place for...
Well, hard drives or whatever, those external hard drives. Things that you maybe use regularly, but not every day. You don't want them sitting on the top, so you have them stored somewhere. Okay.
Got it.
And then I like this one. Set up a common charging spot. So, you know, pick a place and then everyone can go plug their phones in. Kind of like when you go to the conferences and, you know, they have the charging station.
At the airport, everyone fights over that one seat next to the plug.
Yeah, but you have something with maybe multiple adapters there. Yep. And everyone knows where their phones are, too. And you
good
won't
idea.
Lose your phone either.
All right.
All right, so that's it. Go check out professional-organizer.com, Spring Organizing Technology Edition. All right, next one
third
up.
One, the Shauna Method, killing plants and accumulating clutter.
That sounds like it should go on my business card.
You do have a dead plant that's been in your office for a while.
For a while.
2 years.
Yeah,
we decided 2 years it's been there.
2 years, oh boy. Ever well, that's because ever since Carmen retired, Carmen, if you're watching.
She was your gardener.
She'd come in like every, you know, once a week and water. She'd tell me, don't overwater this, you know. It's
so
okay, I won't touch it at all, you know. And the thing would flourish and then she'd go on vacation and the thing would wither and then she'd come back and it would, you know.
And now she's been retired for 2 years. Yeah, so. The plant still sits in
I have
water.
A nice, it's not even a plant anymore. I think it's decomposed into
a nice pot,
a pot of dirt.
Yeah.
Right, and some kind of rude
looking.
Yeah,
you should probably bring that home.
Okay.
That dirt is probably moldy in there.
Well, what does Shauna have to say about
basically
this?
Basically, it's a plant life kind of correlating
like
with
analogy or something.
Analogy with organizing. So plants are great. They're lively. They freshen up the space.
We love plants.
If you have a dead plant,
Nobody likes that.
Maybe you're the type that maybe accumulates or you struggle with clutter.
It could be very, very true.
Okay, first, plants need to be planted.
Okay.
They need their own container, their own planter, just like your clutter.
You need the right size container,
too.
You don't want it too big, not too small.
You have to have the right type of things, of storage containers to organize your things.
Yes.
You don't want it to be...
Right.
Whatever.
And don't go buy the containers first.
Well,
you measure. You know, that's one of our common tips we hear. So same probably with plant. You make sure you get a plant that's big enough because the root system's going to go out this big. So you better get a plant container that big. Okay.
Second, plants need regular care and repetitive care.
Okay.
So you're not just going to plant it and let it go unwatered or untrimmed or anything.
Most people wouldn't do that.
So the same with your clutter. You need to maintain it.
Okay.
If you put it away and it gets brought out the next day, put it away.
Right.
Don't just let it pile up.
Keep everything in its place.
Keep everything in its place. Exactly.
Nice, nice.
It means spending daily time.
Yes.
Kind of upkeep.
Yes.
Third, plants periodically need some tweaking. So they might need to be moved. Maybe the sunlight has shifted due to the season. Maybe it's outgrown its pot.
Yeah.
Maybe it needs a haircut. Same thing with clutter. Maybe, maybe you've, you know, outgrown some things
probably.
In your house and you need to get rid of them.
Right.
And then finally, plants will ultimately need to be purged. They're eventually they will die unless you have one of those really, really, really green thumbs, and the plant can be passed down from generation, like those Christmas cactuses.
Oh yeah,
those things last like 100
forever.
Years.
Yeah. Yeah. Or if you have like the other plant of mine that looks great,
that your fake one.
The fake one.
Yes. Been, I know.
It's looked great since the first day I bought it 7 years ago.
Exactly.
Oh well.
So anyway, sometimes clutter like plants need to move on. Like your plant, that's not a plant anymore. That's just dirt.
Right.
Needs to get.
We're going to recycle that outside because, you know, we have the plant
committee. Yeah, you can just dump the
garden committee here. I'm gonna take it to their next committee meeting and say, I've got a pot of dirt. Could you guys use this somehow? Recycle it.
You could probably give them the dirt and you could take the planter and either use it at home or bring it to a donation center.
Or I could use that planter to break my window in case there's an intruder. That's what I've always kind of, that's kind of why I'm.
Well, that's a great idea. Then don't dump the dirt out.
That's
because
true.
The planter alone will not break that window.
Yeah.
You need the dirt in there for force.
For force. Okay.
Okay.
Let's put that slide up again.
Yes, that's the Shauna method, killing plants and accumulating clutter.
All right. Whew.
Great vlogs this week.
And it's Thursday and no show tomorrow. Sorry, folks. We're dark tomorrow and we'll be back next week. We're not going to get into your next week's schedule because who knows what's going to happen next week. You're going to have to just come back on Monday, 2 p.m. Central, 3 Eastern, noon Pacific, to find out what our plans are.
Exactly.
Because we're still working on them right now. But we'll be here Monday for sure. So
enjoy come back. Your weekend.
Yeah, have a great one and we'll see you on Monday.
Get organized in color at myorganized.life. myorganized.life.